Good morning, friends. Right now it's 7th of August, 5:20 a.m. If you think I am mad and eccentric, you are right. Now, something I've been thinking about, and it's very, very relevant, because I know lots of you are suffering from a similar problem. It is called FOMO. And FOMO is not just a problem in the market. It is a problem in life. Each one of us has missed out certain things in our life, and missing out is a traumatic event. You know, it changes your entire belief in life, which means somebody wanted to go to IIT, could not make it. Somebody wanted to go into IAS, could not make it. And the environment around, you know, made that person feel not up to the mark, for which, you know, that has been ingrained in his psychology. Somebody didn't get the girl he wanted. Somebody didn't get the job he wanted. So, what starts to get ingrained in people is the fear of missing out. So, what he starts to do, post that for the rest of his life, is that when he sees something on offer, again, you know, his traumatic story starts to replay in his mind, and he tries to grab at it. Now, at certain places, it works very, very well. Why? Because the person is taking initiative because he has the fear of missing out. In life also, if you try to grab at things, often they will slip out. If you let them come to you, you will often be able to achieve them. But still, because FOMO at least makes you take the initiative, so you are playing life on the front foot, and it may not be that big of a disadvantage. In the market, what happens is that if you have this fear of missing out, you will try to grab at trades before they have matured. You will try to grab at trades before they have reached your pre-decided location. Okay. So, it makes you impatient. And, you know, if all of you try to look back, you will see that certain events in your life have made FOMO very, very strong. And if you become aware of when that FOMO is hitting you, your trading will become better. Your entries will become better. Now, FOMO is not just before you enter a trade. FOMO also happens after you enter a trade. Why? Because the moment you see a 5 rupee profit, you are grabbing at it. Why? Because you are scared that it may be taken away from you. And hence, you never let a trade mature. Hence, each time what you are doing is that you have your little profit and you just cannot let it ride. You just cannot follow a system of trade management where you are updating your stop losses, where you are letting the trade get to its full potential. So FOMO is a big, huge problem. I would think it is a problem in life. It is a problem in trading, but in trading it gets magnified. The best, you can say, the most successful people and the most successful traders should be able to wait and wait and wait, should be able to do nothing for hours and for days, and the results can be dramatically different. And that is why they say that 80% of trading is psychology. Now you may know the whole thing very well. You know where the right place is for entries. But because of your FOMO situation, if you are grabbing at things the moment market opens, and you are grabbing at your profits the moment you turn green, you know, your performance will be fairly mediocre. It can be compared to any sport. If you are reaching out to a ball while you are batting outside the off stump, that reaching out will often lead to edges and you will get, you know, caught in the slips. If you wait for the ball and play it late, you will time it much better. Okay. In archery, if there is too much effort, you know, your arrow will not go to its target. You will be putting too much stress on the entire bow and arrow, etc. It has to be effortless. And if you are aware of your FOMO problem, any weakness, any problem that you are aware of, the moment you know you start to get the familiar urge to act, you should be able to deal with it. And the best way to deal with it is stand up, take a walk, and let that urge come off. Now, this is a game that you have to play with yourself, because you know, if you are sitting there and you are getting these FOMO type urges, you are likely to make the mistake you don't want to make. So the best way is get up, take a walk, have a glass of water, have coffee, just move away from that situation, from the heat of the battle, for like 5 odd minutes, and then come back and again refocus. Because FOMO urges, they are momentary. Once you start to see those urges subside, and once you have certain body changes, like some heartbeat goes up or some churning of the stomach, you know FOMO is coming. So I think this can be fixed with practice, and your life will become much better if you stop grabbing at things, worrying that they may get out of your hands. I hope this little video on FOMO helped, because this is a major issue, whether or not you believe me, but you will see that this is what makes you act in an impatient manner both before and after a trade. That should be it. Take care, trade well, and please consult your financial